What is happening in the brain when we hear music we enjoy? And could music play a role in improving health of older adults and their caregivers? While this field of research is still young, scientists supported by the National Institute on Aging, part of the National Institutes of Health, are studying music's therapeutic potential. Dr. Psyche Louie is working to understand how music affects neurotransmitters in the brain. According to Louie, our brains are hardwired to predict and anticipate familiar rhythms and melodies.
When we hear something that we enjoy, that engages not only the auditory cortex, but also the reward system. About music from adolescence through young adulthood is especially good at engaging that reward system.
Her research team is exploring if connections between music and this reward system could help revive learning and memory function in older adults with cognitive impairment. Other scientists study music's ability to soothe and calm. Dr. Darina Petrovsky is testing if music can improve mood and sleep quality for people with advanced dementia, which could also improve quality of life for their caregivers.
And my work since then has focused on using music with individuals living with Alzheimer's disease and related dementia, and specifically focusing on ways music can be used to address behavioral and psychological symptoms, aggression, depression, anxiety, sleep disturbances. My postdoctoral clinical trial, which was also funded by the NIH, focused on introducing preferred sleep-inducing music right before bedtime. If you're listening to something with less beats per minute, it will bring your arousal state down.
Dr. Julian Johnson is testing if music could strengthen connections in older people to reduce social isolation and loneliness.
We received funding for the Community of Voices study, which was examining whether or not singing in a community choir was good for psychosocial health, cognitive health, and physical health. We started 12 new choirs in San Francisco, and older adults, it was almost 400 older adults participated in those choirs for a year. And after they finished their year in the study, all 12 of those choirs continued. And we're finding that in a lot of our studies, folks who have never engaged in music are interested in learning music. So that's really exciting for us because we think that this is a really important potential avenue for keeping older adults engaged and interested in life.
While more research is needed, scientists are intrigued by the potential of music as medicine.